After this presentation, there will be a short tea break for 15 minutes.
Good morning, everybody. Today, my presentation is pediatric obstructive sleep apnea. First of all, thanks, Professor Khurshed Mazumdar, for inviting me in this conference. I am not a good orator, but I am very much experienced surgeon. Believe me, I have done at least 2000 pediatric OSA surgery last few years with different instruments. So you may ask any question after my presentation. About my experience, I will share definitely. So, pediatric OSA and adult OSA, there is a two difference, main difference. In pediatric OSA, mainly due to static obstruction. But in adult, why is very difficult? Because the dynamic obstruction also added. So, pediatric obstruction result is fantastic. Definitely. So, I am the medical director of this hospital. I have a small ENT super specialty hospital. 16 bedded. Now, in adult, both dynamic and static obstruction present already told. The symptoms. The snoring definitely important, but in case of adult, more important is the snoring. But in case of children, snoring is not most important factor. Position of breathing, restless sleep, snoring, snorting, coughing and choking is very important. In the morning, mouth breathing, bed wetting, sleep terror. Some important associated factor, poor performance in school, difficulty in paying attention, learning and behavioral problem, poor growth, hyperactivity. Already told, the unlike adult snoring is not the main clinical features in OSA in children. Now, causes, important. Enlarged tonsil adenoid are the major cause of OSA in children, but adenoid is the most important. Besides this, definitely obesity, turbinate hypertrophy, septum, craniofacial anomalies, and neuromuscular disorder also. Down syndrome, we also keep in the mind. Sometimes Down syndrome baby also present with the adenoid syndrome, adenoid also. Other risk factors, cerebral palsy, sickle cell disease, family history of OSA, low birth weight. How the obstruction, basically adenoid and tonsil. Routine questionnaire to the parents. Does your child snore? No, sir. Yes. If you ask the leading question, then slight. What you have observed about your child's sleep and disturbed sleep? Majhe majhe uthe boshe. Does your child have problems paying attention? Does your child have learning difficulties? Any family history of OSA? And you ask the patient, party, bangle bolchi, apnar bachcha ke ha kor thake? Na sir, ha kor thake na. Acha, apnar bachcha ke mukh ta ektu khule thake? Ha sir, mukh ta khule thake. Kintu apnar important basically leading question. So, possibility of denial, activity is the denial basically. The diagnosis. So, main diagnosis is not a X-ray, soft tissue nasopharynx. Believe me, the endoscopy is the, I think, the best diagnosis. Neither endoscopy. X-ray, polysomnography, oximetry, ECG, this is less common in case of children. So, nasal endoscopy is the most, in our institute, we are regularly doing rigid and flexible nasal endoscopy to diagnose with the examination of the oral cavity definitely. The diagnostic nasal endoscopy in open. Look here, in a 5 years child, we are doing regularly nasal endoscopy, and 2 years of my assistant doctor already doing 2 years in front of the guardian. So if you do nasal endoscopy, so correct, you will be confident, your patients will be confident, there is a mass will be there, definitely big adenoid, and you will be sure after operation also I will give the relief, definitely. So X-ray, I don't believe X-ray, sometimes definitely required some hyperactive child, sometimes very, still we are trying with the wrapping, we are trying to do nasal endoscopy. It's a picture basically. So when a patient party will see this type of, and patient also will convince about the surgery, and you also confident after operation patients will be definitely benefited. And also in if in after operation also some problems if there, definitely you will show this is the not a sin, previously it was sin. So some doctors claim if I do also curative method, there is no chance of recurrence. But believe me, I have done now regularly. So I have done at least much more recurrent adenoid surgery. Because the, if I do surgery, then regular problem, the patient does not go to that doctor. So that doctor does not know the recurrence occur basically. So recurrence occur. In Manchester, just 3 months before one doctor does the adenoidectomy and tonsillectomy, 2 years of age, but I think conventional, and after 2 months, no benefit, irritated party again came to me, and look here, there's a huge adenoid in 2 years of age. So after 2 months recurrence, basically not recurrence, residual was there, and just a regrowth with allergy. So the recurrence is there, so you should do under vision, definitely. So definitely there is a medical management. Internal corticosteroid, multiple sodium, antihistamine. Antibiotic, not the any importance except infection. So a bachar antibiotic, our bachar comedian, adenoid tonsil, no role, basically. So, but we are lucky, patients already taken 2 years internal steroid, 2 years of multiple sodium, because the pediatrics and given the guarantee to reduce the adenoid tonsil with the intranasal corticosteroid and multiple sodium. So already they claim patients party also told please give the some medicine and the medicine do with already the 3 bachar nahi aschha medicine. So no medicine. If enlarged adenoid, enlarged tonsil, then definitely you should treat the properly. Now other modality definitely positive airway pressure therapy, CPAP, BiPAP, oral appliance, dental device or mouthpiece. Now management. So adenoidectomy already told, tonsillectomy, turbinoplasty also I do the with microdebrider, not with coblation, microdebrider, tunnel tip turbinoplasty, septoplasty, endoscopic septoplasty, and sparectomy also sometimes. And reduction of sulpingopharyngeal throat in case of selected teenage patients group, 14 years, 12 years, sometimes sulpingopharyngeal fold big due to obesity also. I do this way, I show that. But adenoidectomy is the more important than tonsillectomy in case of OSM children. Now, the endoscopic adenoidectomy microdebrider, that Sandra also asked that. Definitely, it is the good technique also. The microdebrider adenoidectomy, you may do this also under vision. But nowadays, last 6 years, I am not doing, sometimes in adult I do this technique, but in with the coblation, that is the more advantage coblation, no bleeding, 100% removal possible, up to sheath, up to periosteal sheath, not possible, and there is a chance of recurrent reaction and hemorrhage also. So definitely coblation more preferred instrument for me also. But it is possible with microdebrider. Now look here. So yesterday some problems with the non atmosphere, but if you see with the HD camera, this is a picture. Look here, not taken the big time. It will take 15 minutes, and now I show slowly how your wind will be going from upwards to downwards, and all plane will be seen, and every structure will be clearly seen, and just movement started. Look here, all times wind electrode will be seen. So suddenly if you introduce within the gland, there is a chance of bleeding. But if you do this way, all structure will be seen automatically, all tissue will be enveloped, and within few minutes you will see without any drops of bleeding all tissue will be ablated.
present is a
So this way clearly, and if you show the recording to the party also will be convinced, okay, fantastic surgery is done. So they will be happy, because the sometimes after operation also sometimes a few days nasal obstruction, but you are sure that you have done 100% correct job, so there is no chance of recurrence also. And also you will see the periosteal sheath, perimycial sheath, every aspect. And if DNS also, no problem, because the in one side nasal cavity you will able to do 80% 90% of your surgery. So if you put the after that one just angle endoscope, you will see everything. And you see that opposite side all will be completed. You see, look the sheath, perimycial sheath. So 100% removal possible with the this technique. Do incision tuberosity, should do. So beautifully it will be possible, not possible with the micro debrider. Now this is the picture, is the micro debrider, and this is the compression, that is definitely better. Main advantage, no chance of recurrence and reaction in anybody in case of tonsil also. Because if you do any technique, there is a chance of reaction in hemorrhage. But in coblation, there is no chance of primary and reaction in hemorrhage. Secondary hemorrhage definitely will be there. But if you follow the, if you do regularly, then recurrence reaction hemorrhage is very, very less, negligible. My preference after coblation, tonsillectomy, you just give to the patient tranexamic acid for 10 days. There is no chance of reactionary secondary hemorrhage if you done good job. Here, tonsilling the plane is the main important. If you see the plane from upper pole, automatically machine will be do surgery. It's very simple surgery. Tonsil bar is very difficult for initial surgery. There is a chance of huge hemorrhage, basically. More than normal tonsil, huge chunks of hemorrhage, bleeding and uncontrollable bleeding. And you will enter the muscle plane and then massacre. It's the perimycial sheath. If you dissect properly, there is a chance of bleeding, but automatically you will block it. Purposefully I am showing this bleeding, because the automatically no chance of tension, simply all sheath would be seen, all perimycial sheath, muscle, no injury of the muscle here also, just change of holding and your operation will be done within 1 minute, 2 minutes, and be happy. There is no verification, no mouth gag and packing, change the mouth gag to see that again and again bleeding. It's simple, just operation complete. You just go there in the sitting room, take a break and coffee, take the coffee, and no tension at all. Simply tonsillar tissue and peritonsillar fiber and muscle all will be seen properly under, definitely under microscope. I will prefer definitely under microscope all time. Other microscope I never do any tonsil, because all small vessels, perimycial fiber, perimycial sheath, everything is clear. So now definitely there is a lot of advantage, definitely surgeon's advantage, patient's advantage, better patient outcome, minimum pain, fast recovery, reduced post-op pain, less frequent use of analgesic, and most important surgeon's benefit, one device, tonsil adenoid, shorter operating time, this is most important. These are hemostasis, variable coagulation, and few post-op call. Only complain after tonsillectomy, only the pain. But if you counsel before operation, no call, basically, no hemorrhage, nothing. Same day discharge, and you will enjoy. My patients will go the same day after 3 hours, after 3 hours surgery. Okay, after OSS surgery, after 3 hours, and you will enjoy just morning operation time, and afternoon, where you sit the chamber, patients will come and just take a picture and goes there with smile face. Some patients go blitter bottom. So you will enjoy basically, and three surgery or 20 patients will go. No headache at all. Because you know, there is no main complaint is the hemorrhage. So you know that there is no chance of primary hemorrhage, there is no chance of reaction hemorrhage. And question about the secondary hemorrhage. If you place the good antibiotic, good gargling, and if you do surgery properly, and just put the 10x medicine, because the only if secondary hemorrhage, the only treatment is the only pause, no admission basically required in this normal technique, not with this technique. But in normal tonsillectomy, there is a profuse bleeding. Here only spit out the. So there is no chance of secondary hemorrhage. So no headache. Only call the pain. So you are counseling, the pain will be there definitely after 2 to 3 days, up to 7 days pain. But if you ask the proper gargling and taking food, so less call. So headache is less for surgeon also. There is Anandamayi Patrika as the main paper, and it comes all are quoted my name basically, that now popularize the coagulation technology there. The tarpinoplasty is very important. Tarpinoplasty. Sometimes only not adenoid tonsillectomy is the sufficient for also periodic OSA. So tarpinoplasty required. Why unnecessary tarpinectomy? Here the tarpinoplasty possible. Simple block and hydrodissection required basically before surgery. And small leak. And you see the tunneling. Automatically all will be shrinkage. As the microwave is a good instrument, and all surgeons have microwave better because we are the endoscopic sinus surgery. So with turbinate blade is there, or pedetic blade is there. Tricut pedetic blade. You may use the tricut pedetic blade. So automatically turbinate will be reduced. Easy. So up to nasopharynx will clearly check the automatic all opening will be there. Some bones will be destroyed, sometimes bone will be removed through the tunnel. So this is the tarpinoplasty. And good result, no injury of the mucosa. Now reduction of salpingopharyngeal polyp. So salpingopharyngeal fold, in case of 12 obesity, sometimes prefer the to reduce the salpingopharyngeal fold also. It's a fantastic result. Look here how. This is a salpingopharyngeal fold. So in adult also required, but in pediatric also required salpingopharyngeal fold, because if you do inflexible nasal endoscopy, you will see the all folds collapse. So you should remove this. And if you remove, then picture will be this way. Beautifully, it will reduce both ways. So salpingopharyngeal fold diminished. Now the sparectomy and septoplasty endoscopy guided required sometimes in case of children also. Just block and endoscopy guidance. Small incision sometimes required according to your block. So simply sometimes required also. So not only adenoid tonsil sufficient, sometimes if block is not, you just counsel the patient party that one day pack will be there, just remove it. Now just think about your own daughter. If your own daughter has a problem, suffer, then you will give the best result and you want the best instrument. So think about this way. I want the best result. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for patience, and thank you
Thank you, Dr. Tushar Kanti Ghosh. He's delivering his topics on pediatric OSA, and we watch, observe I have one question. In which case you deduce the surfing of an Indian fold?
In case of obesity and less adenoid, size reduced adenoid, but big sulking of pharyngeal throat blocking the coming the main line.
What is the parameter of big sulking of pharyngeal throat?
Parameter basically measurement basically, but if you look, the it touches the main line,
yeah,
or nearly touches.
So does it create any problem after surgery in middle ear?
No sir, no middle ear problem, because you don't remove the total uterine tuberosity, just the fold lower portion only.
Okay, thank you. Any questions from the audience?
No. Now we would like to have a 15 minutes short tea break.